Oh, don't worry. I'll give you the money for both tickets. I have a 5-lever note. We'll change it after the match.
Thanks, Julie. You know, Father and Mother are very decent. They let me take up whatever sport I like. But I can't understand Father's hints about my falling behind at school.
I see his point. As he is a teacher in the same school, he would be terribly ashamed if we weren't among the best students. And many boys do badly at school because of sports.
But I haven't lowered my grades in a single subject.
No, you haven't. But you take very little time over your lessons. You have a good memory. Mine isn't bad, but I can't learn this way, although I'm also at the top of my form. Of course, it matters a great deal to Father. Anyhow, he won't worry after the promise you gave last night.
And I'll keep it, too. I'm so excited about the match. You see, there have been some changes in the national team. The halfbacks are new young footballers, and the goalkeeper is new too. They say he plays like a devil. You see, we win even if the score is a draw, because the first match was 2-1 in our favour.
Well, we'll see. Let's hurry. I'm beginning to feel excited myself.
Fine. I like you this way, old boy.
Hello, Dora. Did you manage to get home dry?
It was really terrible. I never expect such a downpour, so I left my umbrella at home. If Nadia's husband hadn't taken us in his car, I should have been soaked.
You were lucky indeed. Oh, look, Dora. What changeable weather we're having today. There's the sun coming out again from behind the edge of that cloud.
What a lovely sight, Peter. Look at the raindrops sparkling on the flowers and on the leaves of the trees. It's hard to believe that there was such a thunderstorm with lightning only an hour ago.
There's a rainbow. Do you see it?
Where is it? Ah, yes. I see it now. Wonderful. Peter, let's go down to the garden. I love to be outside after a storm. The air is so moist and fresh. The garden smells very fresh and clean.
All right, dear, but let's first open the windows.
I'd better put on my cardigan. It's quite cold. I don't want to miss the beautiful sunset behind the mountain.
Do you remember the proverb? A red sky at night's the shepherd's delight. The lovely sunset reminds me of summer. What about your holidays? When are you going on leave?
About the end of July, say about the 20th.
Good. It's the height of the season. Are you taking the whole of your leave?
No. I'll leave part of it for the winter. It would be nice if we could all of us go to a winter resort too. Don't you think so?
Of course I do. We can go to Borovitz. The children love skiing. It's high time for Nelly to give up her sledge and take up skiing. But we're going too far with our plans. Let's discuss the summer holidays first.
Okay, Peter. Do you insist on going to Sozopol again?
Not if you'd like to go somewhere else for a change. You probably have a new place in mind.
Yes. You know, we haven't had many amusements all this year. In fact, we had very few in the winter and almost none in the autumn and the spring. I'm sure you'll accept my idea of going to Varna.
Of course. Why should we always go to Sozopol? I'm sure the children will be delighted too. Do you remember when Alan, Mr. Thomas's son, is going to the Golden Sands?
Yes, almost at the same time as we are. He can join us. Tony and Julian will have the chance of practicing their English. They'll take him swimming and boating. They'll show Alan the nearby beauty spots. We could both join the children for an excursion to Nisseba and Sunny Beach. We can all have a very nice time in spite of the crowds of holidaymakers.
Of course we can. Look, the boys are coming.
Hello, boys. Father and I have been talking about going to the seaside this summer. Don't you think July is the best month to go?
Yes, The sea is calm and warm in July and the first half of August. During the second half, there's usually a break in the weather, and the sea becomes rough. Usually September is very warm and sunny.
Yes, but then the sun is not so hot as it is in July and August, and one can't get a good tan.
Can't one just? Why, we both of us get tanned. But neither Mother nor Nelly do, as they have a fair complexion and sit under a sunshade most of the time.
I don't like sitting in the shade. I like making sand castles.
I don't either, but I prefer underwater fishing instead.
Is that a new hobby of yours?
Why not? Alan writes he wants us to find a harpoon for him, so that he needn't bring one from London. The letter arrived in the afternoon. Here it is. You can read it yourself.
That explains your new hobby. Let me see the letter. So, Alan is coming at the end of July. Mother, when are we going to the seaside?
At about the same time, Julie.
Hooray! So we'll meet him. Will he be staying with us, Mum?
Yes, Tony. Peter, you must write to Mr. Thomas to arrange everything about his arrival.
And what about the harpoon, Dad?
Don't worry, my boy. We'll buy one. You just study your lessons, and Mother and I will see to it that everything is all right.